Elizabeth Sawyers, also known as Sanit of Cherry Hill St. George, who resided in England, passed away on Thursday, 21st September 2023 in England at the age of 72. She was the former wife of Roy Sawyers, mother of Maureen, Patricia and Angela, grandmother of Natasha, Roy, Shireen, Reese, Anthony, Rushan, Richard, Danielle, Byron and Brianna, great-grandmother of Cassius and Nova, many cousins, other relatives and close friends including Joan, Patsy, Louise, Jonah Mayday, Leslyn, Nesta, Alwyn, David, Esther and Junior, the Livingston and Giddens families, Rachel, Cecilia, Pansy, Donica, Francis, Eleanor and Icy, and friends and neighbours in England and at Fontenoy, Cherry Hill and surrounding areas. The funeral service for the late Elizabeth Sawyers, also known as Sanit, of Cherry Hill St. George, who resided in England, will take place on Tuesday, 21st November at 1 p.m. Funeral service will be held at the Garden of Remembrance Funeral Chapel, Cemetery Hill St. George's, according to Catholic rites, and entombment will be at the St. George's Centre Cemetery. Funeral arrangements entrusted to Lacqua Brothers Funeral Home. Imelda Lucy Abraham, also known as Tanti Loom, of Vincent St. David, who resided at Paddock St. George, passed away on Monday, October 30th, 2023, at the age of 84. She was the mother of Trevor Abraham, John, Ray, Ricky and Lyndall Cole, and Sheridan Leo, also known as Sherry, grandmother of Sheree Medley, Renisha Clark, Kyle Leo, Joshua, Nyamke, Nylon, Fidel, Chavez, Johnny and Shai Cole, Shanice Liebert Cole, Naya Cummings, Giovanna Abraham, Neswan Greenwich, and Olivia McQueen, great-grandmother of five, mother-in-law of Gemma Andrews Cole, Sharon, Michelle and Erica Cole, and Lucy Abraham and Landa Leo, sister of Alban Abraham and family, sister-in-law of Teresa Abraham and family, several nieces and nephews, including the Seventh-day Adventist Church family of Archibald Avenue, and friends and relatives in England, Canada, Trinidad, the USA, Paddock St. George, and Vincent St. David. The funeral of the late Imelda Lucy Abraham, also known as Tanti Loom, of Vincent St. David, who resided at Paddock St. George, will take place on Wednesday, November 22nd at 1 p.m. Funeral service will be held at the Seventh-day Adventist Church, Archibald Avenue, St. George's, and entombment will be at the St. George's Centre Cemetery. Funeral arrangements entrusted to Lacqua Brothers Funeral Home. Gerlin Robertson of Telescope St. Andrew passed away on Saturday, October 28, 2023, at the age of 68, left to mourn her husband David Robertson. She was the mother of Ken, Nolene, Solange in Grenada, and Rhonda in the USA, grandmother of Travis, Javon, Devani, and Kaylee, sister of Gemma and Nick in the USA, Nathalina and Nicholas in Grenada, Phileas and Oliver in the UK, mother-in-law of Robin in the USA, Jade and Ninica in Grenada, sister-in-law of Queenie in the USA, Jeanette in the UK and Tony, Jean, Shirley, Amigo and Avon in Grenada, aunt of many including Suzanne and Wayne in the USA, Esther, Richard, Peter and Boyle, numerous friends and relatives including the Congregation of Jehovah's Witnesses, Linda Lee in Trinidad, Sherry Bain in Carriacou, Angelo, Emo, the Jeremiah, Lessie, John, Felix, Lewis, Robertson and St. Cyr families, and neighbors and friends of Telescope, Grenville, Union and surrounding villages. The memorial service for the late Gerlin Robertson of Telescope St. Andrew will take place on Wednesday, November 22nd at 1 p.m. at the Kingdom Hall of Jehovah's Witnesses, Melody Lane, Telescope St. Andrew. Funeral arrangements entrusted to Lacqua Brothers Funeral Home. Evelyn Mary Barry of Grand Mall St. George, Supervisor of Customs and Excise Department, passed away on Sunday, 29th October 2023, at the age of 52. She was the daughter of Emma Barry and Donald Mitchell, also known as Anthony Philip in the USA, sister of Rosalyn, Donald Lynn and Jason in the USA, Charlene, Antonio and Anthony in Grenada, aunt of Rosim and Kylie in the USA, her partner Willie Noel, sister-in-law of Jem Thomas Barry and Mervyn Mitchell, niece of Carol, Jacqueline, Stanley and Winston in Grenada, Leon, Ingrid, Curtis and Charles in Trinidad, Merle, Patsy, Joseph, William and Jane in the UK, cousin of many including Ronnie, Romond, Vanessa, Brittany, DeLeon, Althea and Leanna in Grenada, Nita, Joseph, Rhea, Chelsea and Milan in the USA, Kiffy, Nevin and Daniel in Tortola, cousin-in-law of Rhea Sylvester. Many other relatives and close friends, including the Barry family of River Road, Molinaire, Dr. Bell, Victoria and in Trinidad, the McBurney and Sylvester families of New Hampshire, the Stanislaus family of Beaulieu, the Lewis family of Fontenoy, the Roberts family of Rosehill, the Richard family of Brazan, the Thomas family of Marigot, Ravine and Boca, Enon Mitchell and family, Father Carl Haynes and family, Vaughan Haynes, Luther Redhead, Elvis Lewis, Dr. the Right Honourable Keith Mitchell, Adrian Joseph, Richard Griffith, Andre Donald, Margaret Mitchell, Bessilla Noel, Cheryl Chaiton, Stafford St. Clair, Elias Sylvester, Algernon Belfon and family, Shamara Lecret and family, Rollin Rennick, Zara Sinanen, Ursula Hector, Karen Forsyth Hall, the staff of Customs and Excise Department, Dr. Jude Antwine and family, Drs. Linwald Flary and June Francis, Dr. Lopez, and friends and neighbors of Grand Mall and surrounding areas. The funeral of the late Evelyn Mary Barry of Grand Mall St. George will take place on Thursday, November 23rd at 1 p.m. Funeral service will be held at the Grand Mall Seventh-day Adventist Church, and entombment will be at the Wilberforce Cemetery. Funeral arrangements entrusted to Lakwa Brothers Funeral Home.
When a loved one passes on, we all need the comfort, support, and guidance of a trusted friend. You can rely on Lakwa Brothers Funeral Home. We provide a personalized professional service that exceeds all expectations. Our dedicated staff responds to your every need with the greatest detail, ensuring affordability with a variety of options. Upgraded state-of-the-art facilities, spacious air-conditioned chapel with live internet streaming, a modern, environmentally safe crematorium, the only of its kind on island, private viewing spaces, large on-site repast center, a modern transportation fleet. Join our burial society today and make personalized arrangements for that final moment. As you prepare to enter your loved one into eternal rest, visit or call Lakwa Brothers Funeral Home and select a package that brings added comfort to the entire family. Lakwa Brothers Funeral Home and Burial Society, continuing a tradition of excellence.
Anne Antwine, also known as Lezu and Sister Les of Laureland St. David, passed away on Friday, November 3rd, 2023, at the age of 67. She was the wife of David Antwine, also known as CP, mother of Sonia Nelson, Roll and Dave Calist, Shanna, Chanel and Brent Antwine. Grandmother of 14 in the USA, the UK, Trinidad and Grenada, including Shane, Dr. Samira Nelson, Shamika, Shaheen, Brittany, Alexa, Jaden, Sharissa, Shanika, Destiny, Sky, Shamuel, Dondre, Daniel and Ethan. Sister of Teresa, Brenda, Wayne, Frank and Ricky Calist. Mother-in-law of Bernard Nelson, Deandra Marshall and Andrea Aline. Aunt of many, including Janelle, Donnell, Bertie, Toots, Keisha, Sheldon, Chubby, Akim, Cheyenne, Shondi, Alyssa, Kevin, Nicholas, and Nakiba. Caregivers Francine Dominic, Sharon Blackett, and Michael Modu. Many cousins, other relatives, and close friends, including Sister Suzanne Delicia, Sister Brenda Jones, Yvette Payne, Pastor Happy and Thy Kingdom Come Deliverance Sanctuary, the Paul family of Beaton, the Dominic family of Laureland and Confer, Roald Gans of Beaton, Derissa Roberts in England, Nurse Bagwan, Teresa and Agnes Lewis, Doctors Oakey and Houston, Graham Dominic, Agatha Harris and family of Lamode, Pastor George and members of the Beaton New Testament Church, and friends and neighbors of Laureland and surrounding areas. The funeral of the late Anne Antoine, also known as Leso and Sister Les, of Laureland St. David, will take place on Thursday, November 23rd at 1 p.m. Funeral service will be held at the Garden of Remembrance Funeral Chapel, Cemetery Hill, St. George's, according to Pentecostal rites, and entombment will be at the St. George's Center Cemetery. Funeral arrangements entrusted to Lacqua Brothers Funeral Home. Francis Lawrence Mahorn, MBE JP, of Hope City St. Andrew, Managing Director of M&N Hardware Limited, passed away on Tuesday, 7th November 2023, at the age of 53. He was the husband of Beryl Mahorn, son of Errol and Verda Mahorn, brother of Sally Ann, Junior, Nicholson, Alvin, Aaron, Joel and Jude, nephew of many including Errol, Mikey, Rufus, Bernadette, Stephanie, Eula, Rebecca, Winston George, Cherilyn and Sam, uncle of Devon, Corey, Caden, Jaden and Jamari, brother-in-law of Eric, Jerry, Charla, Anisha, Shermaine, Janice, Sherna and Derricka. Many cousins including Winston, Peter, Lynette, Marlene, Samida, Princess, Julie, Ruby, Keisha and Timmy. Many other relatives and friends including the Mahorn, Braffitt, Panchu, Batiste, Japal, Carriman and Celestine families, the Calder family of Latante, Margaret Joseph, Trevor Thompson, Hugh White, Osborne Joseph, Samuel Joseph, Prezi, the pastors and members of the Grenada Bible Holiness Churches, the management and staff of M&N Hardware Limited, Savers Mart Supermarket, F&N Farm Supplies and Premium Sourcing, and friends and neighbors of Hope City and surrounding areas. The funeral of the late Francis Lawrence Mahorn, MBE JP, of Hope City St. Andrew, will take place on Friday, 24th November, at the St. Martin de Porres RC Church, Crowshoe St. Andrew, according to Bible Holiness Rites. Viewing will commence at 11 a.m., tributes at 12 noon, and service at 1 p.m. Entombment will be at the Family Cemetery Grand Bacal at St. Andrew. Funeral arrangements entrusted to Lacqua Brothers Funeral Home. Carlita Chalet Magdalene Bailey, who resided at Sanssouci St. George, passed away on Tuesday, October 3rd, 2023 in the USA, at the age of 43. She will be remembered by her mother, D.N. Bailey Alexis, stepfather, Brian Alexis, children, Kia and Keon, siblings, Carla, Deborah, Brian Jr. and Hakeem, niece, Camille, aunts and uncles, Agnes Bailey Cuffey in the USA, Marita, Richard, Loreen and Jackie in Grenada, and Michelle in the USA, brother-in-law, Kenrick Hagley, many cousins, including Leonardine, Natasha, Karen, Nazarene, Keisha, Danielle and Thurman in the USA, Kendall, Kelvin, Sherma, Lagia, Kayla and Marlena in Grenada, Aisha and Kurt in Canada. Many other relatives and close friends, including Kenny Roberts of Darbo St. George, Janelle Filbert, the Bailey family of Belleplain and Hopevale St. George, the Carter family of Belleplain, the Marshall family in the USA and Grenada, Greta and friends on the St. George's bus terminal, friends of Tony's Bar, Germaine and family, Cutie and family, members of Hillsview, the management and staff of Deco Industries and Service Center, Mr. Colin Francis and Ms. Keisha Noel of Saul Grenada, and the Honorable Peter David. Many other close friends and neighbors of Sanssouci and surrounding areas. The memorial service for the late Carlita Magdalene Bailey, who resided at Sanssouci St. George, will take place on Friday, November 24th at 2 p.m. Funeral service will be held at the New Testament Church of God, Lucas Street, St. George, and entombment will be at the St. George's Top Cemetery. Funeral arrangements entrusted to Bailey's Funeral Home. Edwin Dottin of Happy Hill, St. George, passed away on Friday, November 10th, 2023, at the age of 37. The funeral arrangements for the late Edwin Dottin of Happy Hill, St. George, will be given in a subsequent broadcast. Funeral arrangements entrusted to Lacqua Brothers Funeral Home. Augustine Alexis, also known as Uncle Dolly of Lassager, St. David, passed away on Thursday, November 9th, 2023, at the age of 86. The funeral arrangements for the late Augustine Alexis, also known as Uncle Dolly of Lasseter St. David, will be given in a subsequent broadcast. Funeral arrangements entrusted to Lacqua Brothers Funeral Home. Esther Catherine Frances Williams, also known as Auntie Esther, of Grand Arm St. George, passed away on Monday, November 13th, 2023, at the age of 60. The funeral arrangements for the late Esther Catherine Frances Williams, also known as Auntie Esther of Grand Arm St. George, will be given in a subsequent broadcast. Funeral arrangements entrusted to Bailey's Funeral Home. Edna Elaine Stephen of St. Paul St. George passed away on Sunday, October 29th, 2023, at the age of 89. The funeral arrangements for the late Edna Elaine Stephen of St. Paul St. George will be given in a subsequent broadcast. Funeral arrangements entrusted to Bailey's Funeral Home. Cecilia Ridgway, also known as Nenen and Miss Nell of Mount Carmel St. Andrew, passed away on Monday, November 13th, 2023, at the age of 85. The funeral arrangements for the late Cecilia Ridgway, also known as Nenen and Miss Nell of Mount Carmel St. Andrew, will be given in a subsequent broadcast. Funeral arrangements entrusted to Lacqua Brothers Funeral Home. Cynthia Gibson, also known as Clammy and Mama of Bellevue St. David, passed away on Tuesday, October 31st, 2023, at the age of 79. The funeral arrangements for the late Cynthia Gibson, also known as Clammy and Mama of Bellevue St. David, will be given in a subsequent broadcast. Funeral arrangements entrusted to Lacqua Brothers Funeral Home. Clyde Roberts of Calice St. George, who resided at Westerhall St. David, passed away on Thursday, November 9th, 2023, at the age of 66. The funeral arrangements for the late Clyde Roberts of Calice St. George, who resided at Westerhall St. David, will be given in a subsequent broadcast. Funeral arrangements entrusted to Lacqua Brothers Funeral Home.
The management and staff of MTV extend deepest condolences to those of you whose loved ones have passed on. Thank you for watching.
Verse 13, blessed is the dead that die in the Lord. If your loved one died in the Lord, you have nothing to worry about. You could be confident that that one is in a better place. But what about you who are left behind to mourn? What if you had been called? Were you ready? If you are not ready, you can be ready while you are alive. The word of God says, it's appointed unto man once to die, but after this is the judgment. So you can live, and after death, you're going to live forever. You would not be disintegrated into nothing. You would be living forever. So while you're alive, is the time to be ready to meet the Lord. I would like to encourage you to give your life to the Lord Jesus Christ while you are still on the earth. There is no repentance after death. The time is now. The Lord Jesus Christ gave his life on the cross so that you can have life. And while you are living, it's the time to make it right with the Lord. Jonah said in Jonah chapter 4 and verse 3, it is better to die than to live. So the dead should be happy if they die in the Lord. If you are not sure that you are ready, if your time comes, you can be ready. You can be ready even at this very moment. If you'd only open your heart to receive the Lord Jesus Christ and pray this simple prayer. Just say, Lord Jesus, I am sad because my loved one has gone, but I am left behind and I want to be ready when my time comes. So I'm asking you to forgive me for my sins. I'm asking you to give me eternal life. Forgive me, cleanse me from all unrighteousness. And save me so that when my time comes, I can live with you. I trust that you meant what you said. I trust that you believe the word of God. And as we end this program for you, with you, encouraging you, strengthening you in your time of sorrow, your preparation for your time should be now. God bless you, and see you next time. Amen.